Hi, it's Dorothy Guining with Scrapbooking Quebec, and today I'm here for the YouTube collaboration Stretch the Sketch. We're going to take this Rhonda Palazzari 12x12 sketch and alter it. I'll put links to all the other participants below, so be sure to check them out. My plan is to create a double page spread, but I do plan on creating this page as is, the sketch page, because I absolutely love it. And page two is going to be a complementary page, and it will be a collage style layout. I'll start that process at about 7 minutes in this video, and I will share some tips and tricks on how to create that style page quickly and easily. I find a collage style layout goes well with any kind of layout. It's also a great way to add lots of photos on a layout. Now, before jumping in, I just want to apologize because I had problems with my lighting today. I had some technical issues with a camera that was in the shop and is back in my hands now. Anyway, the still shots at the end will be better and it will be resolved before the next video. Here's what I'm going to be using. It's all from Cartabella's Summer Market collection, and I did do some preparation in advance. That's a frame style foundation with 3 sheets of paper, and I gutted 2 of them, and there is a video on my channel where I show how to do that. I'll link it up below. I'm just showing you the photos. The first two there are matted, and the other ones, I'll use those in the collage at the end of the video. And here are all the papers I have. Some of them came from the paper I gutted from behind the foundation page, and others are just leftovers. I also have the stickers from that Summer Market collection, ephemera, and I'm showing you a bunch of tools. So now what I'm doing is creating my mini foundation page, and you can see the sketch in the top left hand corner right in the middle of this sketch, which dates back to 2013, by the way, but it's still so relevant. There's like this mini page in the middle. So that's what I'm creating, and I'm putting measurements for everything I'm doing on the screen. Now, for those scalloped borders at the bottom left, what I used was my Creative Memories Border Maker system. That's a scalloped cartridge. And I did it in a few different papers, and you're gonna see me flip around a bit, and I do add different colors. I'm a little undecided. But before continuing, I'm making myself a tag. Actually, I make 2. They're in graph paper, and I'm planning on possibly adding some extra journaling. You can see on the sketch, there's journaling all around the mini page. I'm thinking I might need a bit more space. Anyway, as you can see, I'm back to making more scalloped edges. Like I said, I couldn't decide. That smaller photo, I backed it in a few layers of scrap cardstock because I want it to pop off the page a bit. So that has 2 layers of extra cardstock behind it. And now what you see me doing is adhering together the mini page. When I do a page where there's a mini page like this, if possible, I do like to adhere the mini page together before actually adhering it to that main foundation page. And I do that because, for a few different reasons. Number one, it permits me to play around with the actual placement of the mini page. And number two, if I want to add a bit of mixed media or stamping or something, I haven't actually committed. And that's what you see me doing right now. Basically, I put 2 drops from a Stampin' Up! Re-inker bottle in that yellow bowl. I added 3 squirts of water, and now I'm dipping my paintbrush in and I'm flicking it with the other finger, and I'm about 7 maybe inches above my paper when I'm doing it. I'm doing it in the bottom middle almost, and then when I turned off the camera, I ended up putting another spot in the top left, and I also covered up the borders of my frame when I did it because there's a bit of aqua color in there and I didn't want it to get spotted with the black drops. So now what you see me doing is actually adhering the mini page to the foundation, but as you can see, I don't actually have the tags in there yet because I'm still undecided. So before committing to that, I'm going into my decorations. I have my stickers there, I have my ephemera all around me, and I put that banner, which you see on the sketch, on wax paper. It's from the sticker sheet and that bicycle. And now I'm going into my ephemera pieces, and I'm going into the bigger pieces. I actually divided them into two piles, one of them bigger pieces and one of them the smaller pieces. And instead of those tags, I started layering up labels and stuff behind that photo on the left. And I'm liking that. Sorry about you don't see the true color right there, but there's basically a bit of aqua, a little bit of yellow and red. So that's kind of the colors I'm working with. I have them there, I'm thinking I'm liking it, and I did have part of a title on wax paper. Now what I had was, what I was thinking anyway, was Quebec 35 years later, because I'm downtown in my city here, and I moved here 35 years ago as a student, and those are two places I lived as a student. So I'm downtown kind of hanging out as a older adult, I guess, and I'm just having fun visiting all the old places I used to go to when I was a young adult. So on that banner, there are six flags, which is perfect for the word Quebec. So I'm happy about that. I'm sticking that on the banner. And I had put, I'm not sure if I had done it already. I didn't notice on the screen. But anyway, that banner is going to be backed in cardstock because I plan on popping it up on foam adhesive. And I did it because the foam adhesive is there. So I'm popping that up. I have those embellishments in the top left-hand corner I'm happy with. That red label that's there had some words on it that I didn't like, so I just covered it up with another piece of ephemera because I did like the color. And what I'm doing now is drawing a pencil line right around the edge, and that is where I did my journaling off camera, and now you see me erasing it. I didn't do it too far off. It's about, I don't know, maybe an eighth of an inch or three-eighths of an inch or something like that away from that aqua paper. And now I didn't like the title that I had picked, which was 35 years later, mostly because it was just too much. It was too much black on the page. So then I decided to go into the numbers and write 1985 and 2020. And I like that. I think I like it because it's just makes less of a presence on the page. So as you can see, I adhered one to the top left, or sort of top left, and one to the bottom right. And now what I'm going to do is start working on page two. Now I'm not entirely satisfied with page one, but I will get back to that. So what I'm going to do here is you need a 12 by 12 foundation page and another piece that's 11 and a half by 11 and a half that's going to be completely covered up. That's the paper you see with all the letters on it. You're not going to see any of that. And my 12 by 12 piece, the only part you're going to see is the exterior quarter inch, which is why I gutted mine. I want to see that aqua color, you'll see it in a minute, and I put it on pink cardstock that I don't like. That's because I wanted to use that pretty paper on another layout. So now I have seven photos here. So four of them are vertical and three of them are horizontal. And what you see me doing now is I'm going to take this smaller piece of paper, which measures 11 and a half by 11 and a half, and I'm going to completely cover it with photos. But I'm going to start by filling in the borders all around. So there's going to be like a hole in the middle. So as you can see, I've lined up the verticals on the right side and on the left side. And I trimmed those down to 5.5 inches each because my paper is 11 and a half by 11 and a half. And I just took a smidgen off each side, maybe 1/8 of an inch. For the middle on the top and on the bottom, I cut those down to 4 inches by 4 inches. Actually, the space that's left for these photos is a little bit smaller than that, but I'm okay with that. You're going to see me tuck the excess piece underneath those photos on the side. You don't have to be perfect here because once the entire page is made, you're really not going to see if it's perfectly equal. Sometimes I do this and the photos aren't like identical sizes all around, they're all different. But the idea is you fill in the exterior with photos completely wall to wall. Now what I'm doing is adhering that piece, the 11 and a half piece by 11 and a half piece, to the 12 by 12 foundation page. And as you can see, you can only see the exterior quarter inch. Now what I'm going to do is take that middle photo and completely pimp it up. I had to reorient the photo that's on the bottom because I had put it on its side by accident. So now I'm cutting down this middle photo. Now I'm not quite sure what it is. I'll put the measurements on the screen. I think I did mine at 3¾ inch by 4½ inch, and I'm going to put 2 photo mats on it. But this part doesn't matter. What matters is the photo covers up the hole in the middle. So you're going to cut the photo to whatever makes sense to you and the photo. So I'm putting photo mats on this, and then what I will do is I'll add 2 layers of scrap cardstock underneath this as well, just to pop it off a bit off the page. You could also use foam adhesive. And before adhering it, I am going to play around with embellishments a bit. There I go with the scrap cardstock, sticking it underneath. And at this point, I'm not going to decorate it to the extent of the other page. All I want to do is add a repeat of these embellishments, mostly a repeat of the color, a little bit of repetition. You're going to see I add a bit more of the title that I plan to use on the first page ends up going on the second page here. There I go with it. 35 years later, I'm thinking of putting it on that photo of the Chateau Frontenac, which is an absolute landmark in this city. So it hasn't changed in the past 35 years. And there I go with a few embellishments. And all I'm doing here is repeating color. So I want to repeat the aqua, the red, and the yellow. And again, I am sorry for the pale colors here. You're going to see it in just a minute how this actually looks in the end. And that sticker there that says Fun in the Sun, I think, there's a bit of yellow in there. It's not much, but it's enough for me to have that little repetition of yellow on this second page. So once I'm happy with that, I'm adhering it all to the page, and then I'm going to have a look at these 2 pages to see if there's anything I can do to kind of bring these 2 pages together. I have to adhere my title down as well. So you can't really see the title that I'm adhering on the screen here, but in person you can, because these are foam thickers, so there's a bit of dimension to it. There you have it. As you can see, I've figured out my lighting finally. I'm looking at the 2 pages. I'm thinking I want something again on the right-hand side, but I end up just tucking in 1 more piece of ephemera that has a bit of black in it, and I felt that that gave a bit more heaviness, a bit more weight to that embellishment cluster in the top left. And I'm going to call this a day. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to Scrapbooking Quebec if you haven't already. Also, be sure to check out all the other participants. Their links are all listed below. Anyway, have a great day, and thank you so much for watching.